Chris Hughes coming out right now. He is 25 years old. He stands about 5'9". He weighed in at 155 pounds. I mean, I know this guy from up there, one-hit MMA. He is a tremendous striker. Right now, he's never tasted defeat so far in the ring or the cage. He's 2-0 in MMA. He's 4-0 in Muay Thai. This guy has a lot going for him. I know they've invited him to try out for the Olympic kickboxing team. So you may see him busy doing that a lot more, and that kind of shows his striking potential right there. Like I mentioned, he trains out of Wimbledon MMA. And his coaches are Aldo Reggio, Jared Kelton, and Lucas Montoya. So he kind of gets a big grip of people. You know, you've got Lucas and him, they're going to train around. Blackout Jiu-Jitsu, Blackout MMA. You have Jared Kelton that's around, the guys Assassin Jiu-Jitsu. And you have Aldo Reggio as well. So as you can see, he's got a lot of people in his corner. And what else do you know about?
I know he started Muay Thai at the age of 13, and he's been training ever since. His last MMA fight, he won via triangle in the first 26 seconds. He tells us, you know, he's one of those guys that starts out as a striker, you know, and you would think would be one-dimensional. Comes out, wins via triangle early in the fight, you know. But for him, fighting is just fun to do. He's here to have fun.
I just walk in front of that.
Start on
turn him over. Maybe he's about to give up the mount position to avoid this choke.
Watch out for the armbar.
Here comes an armbar submission right now. You see Thomas trying to stack to the fence, but as soon as he stepped over, that kind of, ended up sinking the thing a little bit more, and then Thomas stepped back.
Thomas did a good job of turning into the right position. His arm was really starting to straighten out there, which I've had a blown bicep before, and that is a terrible position.
You see Thomas right now, he's still going for that finish. Cody right now, these guys are putting on a great fight. He's going for that takedown, and takedown, 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 which is a great idea with the striker. He's trying to test Thomas's ground skills. So we're at the end of the round right now. Let's move forward.
Yeah, it works. I think Randy, our cage clinger, is going to be working some overtime.
Yes, he is.
Good to see him put to work.
Yes, he is. Cody came out. He just gave the little hang loose sign to Thomas, letting him know he's all good. Doctor checked him out. I mean, these are some tough kids in here, and these guys have given us a show.
These guys are covered in blood. I love it. And they're still going to touch gloves, show respect for each other, and then start wailing.
All right, Thomas threw some hands right now. Let's see what he does with his kicks. He's changing stances as well, so it's kind of hard to be able to figure out which way he's standing. And he almost caught that single kick again.
Dude, just kicked him twice in his stomach and he's done, dude.
Looks like Hughes coming up right now, which the eyes of the judges that may look like he might be done with.
He's got him, and the rest of it. Thomas Hughes victorious and still undefeated.
Yeah, so Thomas Hughes feels in the cage. Gives I love you sign to his fans, probably to his wife and his kids as well. Great fight, these guys, great show of sportsmanship. Thomas goes to see him, make sure he was okay. Some people don't understand this, but they don't always want to hurt their opponent, but they do want to win.
Yeah.
Sometimes that's what it requires.
And they want to share that war with their opponent. Every opponent I have, you want to share a war with them in that cage, and you want to make that crowd scream their guts out.
Yeah, this is a great thing you can kind of see. Everyone's happy right now.
Obviously.
The Hughes camp, really put up a great performance there. He's there with the crowd for Thomas as well. So let's take it up to the cage and let them finish this one off for us.